Hello and welcome everyone. So in this video we are going to talk about the functions in JavaScript. What are the different ways in which you can declare a function, function expression, function function or passing functions into another functions, and what actually the syntax of the functions are. You might have seen the different variations of the function syntax. So it's something like this: simple functions, function, and say hello. This is the basic function A exists in JavaScript. So if you do the type of, you will get a function. Okay, so this is the basic syntax of creating a function in JavaScript. So even if you do the console.dir to this function, what you will get? You will get a function, and this function, you can see, is having the prototype and the proto, two properties. So functions will have a prototype and the object of the function will have a proto property, and the function scope is defined under it. It is pointing to the global scope. Okay, so I'm talking particularly about this. This is having the prototype and which is pointing to the constructor of the function, and the proto property which will be there with the each and every object you are creating with this function, and the scope of that function which is representing the global scope. Okay, so what are the other ways in which you can create a function? So it is called a function expression, or you can call that as an anonymous function. Okay, this is the basic definition of a function. Okay, now how to call all these functions? It's simple, right? You just call this function like this, or for the first function, how you will call it? Like this. Okay, so in JavaScript, function exists in different variations, and functions are actually powerful. Function can be passed into the another function. So if you talk about the basic simple functions, then we can write some basic snippet of the code. Okay, what we can write? We can write a simple function like so I'm creating a simple function to calculate the cost of the food item. Okay, so if you are your account balance is only 90, right? So I can create a function. So here I can write a simple function where, so if I'm eating the burger, right? So you can put a switch block or something, and you can just return the account balance minus the burger cost. Okay, so you can call these functions, calculate my expense and pass the burger. And here further you can pass the switch block if you are eating. This is the food item, let's say. Here you are passing the food item, and based on the food item you can calculate your cost. So here put a switch block. So here you can put a case. If food item is the first one, then return this. And break. Similarly, you can write the code and you can return the final expenses from this. So this is how we create a function, right? So this is a function, simple function expression we have created. Similarly, we can create a the function, and you can also pass function into another function. So this is very strange, right? Functions, actually JavaScript is not a pure object oriented language. It is mostly a functional programming language. Okay, so we are getting a lot of advantage of having this functional programming language, where JavaScript allowing to inherit the properties from one function to another function. So JavaScript inheritance exists from the day one, like I'm talking about the ES5. Now in ES6 you might be seeing the classes, but the classes are just a syntactic sugar. They are indirectly using the function expressions only to provide the inheritance. So the important thing is, we have seen the function, right? So this function is having all the arguments, methods and name. Here you can see the prototype, right? So let's add something in the prototype of the function. So here I'm having say hello. So now again, if you do this, then in the prototype you will see the x equal to 90 has been added, right? So we are putting few things in the prototype of the function which are available to each and every object we are going to create for this function. So this is why we create a prototype, first of all, because this is a single copy we are managing, and the single copy will be available to all the objects which you are going to create. You don't need to create a separate copy, like say hi, I'm adding. Okay, so I'm adding a function in the prototype. Right, so I have added a function here. So you can see in the prototype now, you are having two things. Say hi is a function and x90 as an argument property, right? And another property is a constructor property. So now if you are going to create an object, let's do it something here. So this is your function, and now what you are doing, you are actually adding some prototype property. Similarly, you are adding functions in the prototype. This is the function you are adding. So this, all these things will get added in the prototype of the function. So whenever you are creating an object, because you have, what is the parent function is this. So this object one, object two, all will have all these prototype properties. Okay. Let's do this. Okay, now I'm created three objects, right? Let's take a look onto the object one. So object one is having say hello, and in the proto of that object you can see all both the variables. Say hi is a function I created, and prototype property x90. Right, so what is the advantage I'm getting is, whenever you are adding the prototype property in the function, that is actually getting copied to each and every object. You don't need to manage a separate copy. So that's why we put the common things in the prototype of a function. So take a look to the examples. Object, you can see, if you see the prototype of an object, you can see all the methods, common methods. Similarly, the array, all these are actually defined in the prototype of the array functions and prototype of an object function. You can see all these methods are there. These all are in the prototype. And similarly, if we do say hello dot prototype dot, we have added say hi and x property in the prototype of this function. Same type we are going to create here, like the array function, capital A array function, or capital O object function. So prototype is going to give us lot of advantage throughout the JavaScript sessions, and this is how we create it, this is how we declare the functions and we call the functions. In the future we will also talk about the self invoking functions. Right now if I wanted to invoke it, I will be doing something like this, right? But there exists a self-invoking function which can invoke himself. What is that? That this is something new, right? Okay, so you will write it. This is called the ify block, immediately invoking IIFE block. Actually, this block is being self-executed. You're not passing, you're not executing anything. The argument you are passing is here. If you're passing argument, you call it like this. It's a self-invoking function. Okay, so next video we'll talk more on the objects and functions.